and welcome to Food and Magic. In this video, you will see a peri-peri chicken sizzler. Sizzlers are best enjoyed in winters and in the rainy season. You can make absolutely delicious sizzlers at home very easily. In this video, you will see the recipe of peri-peri seasoning, herb rice, stir-fry veggies, hot garlic peri-peri sauce, and absolutely delicious peri-peri chicken. So, let's get started. Let's prepare the peri-peri seasoning. For this, I have taken Kashmiri red chili powder 2 teaspoons, garlic powder 1.5 teaspoon, onion powder 1.5 teaspoon, parsley 1 teaspoon, and oregano 1 teaspoon. To this I will add 1 teaspoon of sugar and 1 teaspoon of red chili powder for the spiciness. I'm adding in 1 teaspoon of salt and 1/4 teaspoon of citric acid. This is paprika and I will add 1 teaspoon of it. Mix everything well and grind in a mixer to get a fine powder as we have added parsley and oregano. Remove this in a bowl as we will now make the marinade for the chicken. To this peri-peri seasoning, I will add 2 teaspoons of maida to get a nice coating on the chicken. Add in 1 teaspoon of corn flour and mix everything together well. Here I am adding 1 teaspoon of vinegar. And by adding water little by little, make a thick paste. Add little water, as if it becomes too loose, this process would not be reversible. The paste should not be runny and should be able to coat the chicken uniformly. Here I've taken 4 chicken leg pieces. Make gashes so that the marinade reaches the bones. Coat the chicken liberally with the peri-peri masala and leave it for 2 hours. If you keep it overnight, the taste is even better. After applying the peri-peri masala, I'll refrigerate this. Turn over and apply the marinade. Peri-peri is a South African spicy sauce made with peppers. This chicken will be spicy but not very hot. You can adjust the spiciness by using more of Kashmiri chili powder, which will give more color than the spice. The chicken is marinated. I will cook this in a pan. You can roast it in the oven too. Heat an open pan and add 2 to 3 tablespoons of oil. Place the marinated chicken. Keep the gas on medium-high flame. Just move the pieces so that they don't stick to the pan. And turn them over after 4 to 5 minutes and cover it for 2 minutes. After 2 minutes, add very little water just to produce steam and again cover the chicken. It's been more than 10 minutes and the chicken looks cooked. Let's check it now. Prick with a fork to check if it is cooked. And yes, it is done. Remove it in a plate and set aside. It takes about 15 to 20 minutes to cook the chicken in the pan. This chicken tastes delicious and can be eaten as a starter along with the sauce, which I will further show in the video. Let's make the vegetable stir fry. To 1 liter of boiling water, add 1 teaspoon of salt. Here I've taken some baby corns, broccoli, French beans and carrots in a colander. I will dip the veggies along with the colander and boil for just 2 minutes. Doing so, you can pick up the veggies quickly and dip it in cold water. Do not overcook as we want vegetables to remain crunchy. Can you see how bright the color looks? Now dip into the cold water to stop the cooking process. This will also help to maintain the good color of the vegetables. Dip for only 2 to 3 minutes and then the vegetables are ready for stir frying. In the same pan in which we cook chicken, add a teaspoon of butter. Here I'm adding a teaspoon of chopped garlic and sauté till the raw smell disappears. Here I'm adding in half each of red capsicum and yellow capsicum. As this cooks quickly, I had not parboiled it. Now add in the parboiled vegetables and stir fry on high flame for just a minute. Here I'm adding in 1 teaspoon of honey. These vegetables taste awesome. We have used salted butter, so there is no need to add extra salt. Also, the hot garlic sauce, which we will drizzle when the final plating, has salt added to it. So there's no need to add salt now. Our stir-fry veggies are done. Remove in a plate and set aside. Cover with the aluminium foil till we do the plating. Don't they look so delicious? They taste awesome too. Before we make the other things, place the sizzler plate onto the medium-high flame. It takes about 15 minutes of good heating. Brush little oil to season it. Let's prepare the hot garlic peri peri sauce. In the same pan, add butter. Add in 1 teaspoon of chopped garlic. You can chop finely as per your choice. Saute for a minute and I will add 2 teaspoons of peri peri marinade which we had made for the chicken. Saute this for a minute. Here I'm adding in 2 tablespoons of tomato ketchup. Add little water to make a nice sauce. Keep adding water little by little till desired consistency is obtained. Lastly, add a teaspoon of sugar to balance the tanginess of the sauce. Mix well and a sauce is ready. This sauce is thin and of runny consistency as we are going to pour this onto the sizzler. And here it is ready. Let's make the garlic and herb rice. Add 1 teaspoon of butter in a kadhai. To this I'm adding 1 star anise and after a minute add the chopped red chilies, or you can take green chilies as well, and some garlic and saute till the nice aroma spreads. At this point I'm adding in 1/4 teaspoon of turmeric only because the yellow rice will look nice with the red chicken onto the sizzler plate. You can skip the turmeric at this stage. Add the cooked rice and stir fry for 5 minutes on high flame. I had added salt while boiling the rice and I will not add salt now at this stage. Here I am adding 1 tablespoon of parsley. You can also add dried mint along with parsley and again saute for a minute. And a garlic herb rice is ready to serve. Let's make the French fries. I'm adding in the potatoes to the oil and will deep fry them till they are crispy. And these are nice and crispy in just about 7 to 8 minutes. I will not fry them more as they will start to turn brown from the sides. No sizzler is complete without these crispy fries. Do you agree with me? Let's assemble the sizzler now. Place the cabbage leaves below so that the food does not burn. Here I'm placing the garlic herb rice. Serve the colorful crunchy vegetables. And I will make you hear the wonderful sizzling sound and some more veggies. And here comes the peri peri chicken. Do try this recipe, I'm sure you will love it. And not to miss the crispy fries. This is a 7-inch sizzler plate. If yours is a big one, you can add more variety to the sizzler. And can you hear this sizzling sound? Wasn't that absolutely inviting? It's such a pleasure to hear this sizzling sound when the sizzler is served in restaurants. Now you can make it at home. And a delicious sizzler is ready. Just dive in before the sizzling sound stops. It tastes yummy. So if you like my video, do not forget to like, share and subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching. Thank you.